Welcome to Hereford Cathedral and today's Christmas Sparkle organ concert, which we're putting online for the first time. In a couple of seconds, I'll be disappearing up to the organ loft, where I'll be able to put the Willis organ, which you can see behind me, through its paces in a varied programme of music for Advent and Christmas. The Father Willis organ here at Hereford Cathedral was really designed to accompany the liturgy, and so it's 70 stops, four manuals, the great flexibility and dynamic that you can have through the swell pedals down below with your feet. They're designed really to accompany a great range of Anglican choral repertoire. But it also means that it's a very, very good instrument to play orchestral transcriptions. And I'm sure George Robinson Sinclair, organist here at the end of the 19th century and the beginning of the 20th century, would have played a great number of orchestral pieces upon this organ. And so it's good to carry on that tradition. And the piece I'm now going to play now is one of the movements from Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker Suite, a piece we associate very strongly with Christmas. This is the Waltz of the Flowers. It's the first time in this recital you will hear the glockenspiel stop being used. This is the percussion stop, the little gongs that are high up in the organ. They're quite delicate, so you won't hear them very loudly. But also a variety of semi-orchestral effects that I think are quite beautiful and colourful. And of course, Tchaikovsky's music is simply glorious. So this is the Waltz of the Flowers from the Nutcracker Suite. Just over a year ago, in December 2019, Hereford Cathedral Choir did a quick tour of Italy. And I was lucky enough to be their accompanist, going along playing for them at the concert in Bologna. We didn't know what sort of organ we were going to meet there, but when I met it for the first time in the afternoon of the concert, I discovered it was a 1580 Malomini organ. Extraordinary instrument, absolutely beautiful. And it had a range of wonderful sounds, but very unorthodox. Now, the most unorthodox thing of all was the pedalboard. And I'm now going to just move the bench out, and we're going to get a little shot of the pedals, and I'm going to explain a little bit about what I mean. This is the pedalboard of Hereford Cathedral organ, and this is what we'd call normally expect to play on an organ in the UK. So, as you can see, there are the equivalent of white notes and black notes, just like you might have on the keyboard of a piano. So the system is the same, so if I play this note here, it's a C. If I were to play the organ that I was talking about in Italy, built in 1580, it started at E rather than starting at C, but in fact E didn't play E, it played C. F played F, what looked like an F sharp played a D. What looked like a G was a G, in fact. What looked like a G sharp, in fact, played a bottom E. So I had to relearn, where to put my feet throughout this piece I'm now going to play. That was an extra added layer of complication to our visit to Italy, but one of the great joys about playing the organ is that you have to adapt to the wondrous variety of all the different instruments you meet. This is Cavazzoni's hymn, Christus Redemptor Omnium. I'm standing here by the crib at the foot of the steps to the Lady Chapel here in Hereford Cathedral. I'm going to play three chorale preludes from Germany based on Christmas and Advent hymns. The first of these, A Boy Born in Bethlehem, Puer Natus in Bethlehem, is by the composer Buxtehude, who was organist of the Marienkirche in Lübeck. This is the great church to which Bach walked 260 miles in order to be able to hear Buxtehude's music, which was famous throughout Germany. After that, I'm going to play a piece by Pachelbel. Pachelbel is very well known for his canon, of course, but this is one of his many other works. Pachelbel was an organist in Nuremberg, our linked diocese in Germany. And this one is based on the hymn of the angels, Vom Himmel hoch, da komm ich her. And the angels over there on my left. as I speak. So this is the hymn of the angels to the shepherds. And lastly, an Advent choral prelude by J.S. Bach, the very beautiful Nun kommt der Heidenheiland, which I think for me captures the mood of Advent absolutely perfectly with its gently walking bass and beautifully ornamented chorale melody. So we have three chorale preludes from Germany, Buxtehude, Pachelbel, and the great J.S. Bach.
Thank you.
The next two pieces in the programme today use our unique Glockenspiel stop. Now, as you will know, most of the noise that you hear from the organ, most of the music you hear from the organ, is produced by air going through pipes, and they vary in size from being as small as a fingernail, really, the very highest pipes, to being 10 metres tall, like this great 32-foot bottom C I'm standing next to here. Now, in the next piece, Silent Night, by Gruber, as transcribed by Virgil Fox, you hear both the 32-foot stop we have here and also the Glockenspiel, which is far above our head. The Glockenspiel is a set of gongs which is struck by hammers to produce the note, and there is no other cathedral organ in the UK with such an unusual sound. It's very delicate and you will only just be able to hear it. After that, I'm going to play Leroy Anderson's famous Sleigh Ride in a transcription by Thomas Trotter. This again uses both the 32-foot and indeed the Glockenspiel. I'm standing by the great 32-foot bombard pipes. These great metal pipes behind me are ones you might see as you walk around the south choir aisle of the cathedral. These are only used in the very loudest pieces, and I will use them in the final piece I'm going to play today, the Carillon de Westminster by Louis Vier, who is organist of Notre Dame. This piece is a testament to cross-channel friendship because it was dedicated to Henry Willis himself, who was of course the builder of the Hereford organ. And it is based on the Westminster chimes, which you will hear throughout the piece, amongst a great tintinnabulation representing all the bells sounding across London on a festival day. Before that, I'm also going to play a little French piece by the more modern composer, Jean de Messier. This is an Advent piece based on the Advent prose chorale melody. It's called Rorate Caeli, so drop down ye heavens from above. I find it a very beautiful and meditative piece, very suitable for the Advent season. So, our final pieces today, De Messier, Rorate Caeli, and Carillon de Westminster by Vier. Thank you. thank you for joining us for this year's Christmas Sparkle online organ recital from Hereford Cathedral. Keep an eye on the Hereford Cathedral website for details of future recitals, and in the meantime, I wish you a happy Christmas and a very good New Year.